This is ABC 7 News at 6.
Good evening, everyone, and thank you for joining us. I'm Beth Jones. First tonight, police have made an arrest following reports of gunshots from a Medway residence. AJ Douglas talked to community members left stranded for hours following the closure of a major roadway.
Just trying to get home. I have no other way to go.
Friday, a little after midnight, the East Millinocket Police Department received reports of shots being fired at a residence on Medway Road in Medway. Police say multiple officers arrived attempting to de-escalate.
Members of the East Millinocket Police Department attempted for several hours to make contact with the individual who had barricaded himself inside of his home.
After more than 12 hours, the individual was taken into police custody a little after 1 p.m. However, local residents like Millinocket resident Carol Reeser was left stuck at the intersection of Medway Road and Grindstone Road for hours waiting to get home.
The road was closed. I actually pulled off in the rest area.
A biggest challenge definitely was the motoring public. This happened in, you know, because of, like I said, the location of the incident. This is a major road, and it's essentially the one road in and the one road out of town.
Despite Reeser's patience, she worried about how the traffic standstill would affect an ongoing medical condition.
I am a diabetic, so I'm concerned with no food or anything.
Opal Myrick Elementary School, Medway Middle School, and Skank High School closed due to blocked roadways. Medway Road opened shortly after 1 p.m. following the arrest of the individual who was reportedly firing gunshots. In Medway, AJ Douglas, ABC 7, Fox 22.
The main office of the chief medical examiner has confirmed the identity of the body found by hikers along the shore on Sears Island. They say it is 21-year-old Chase Muchowski. Muchowski had last been seen leaving his dorm at the University of Maine at Presque Isle on October 24th. His SUV was later found that day idling on the Penobscot Narrows Bridge. The medical examiner's office said there is no additional information available at this time. Well, the Kennebec County Grand Jury has indicted a Searsport man on attempted murder charges. 39-year-old Stephen Pratt allegedly fired gunshots into a vehicle in which his ex-girlfriend and her friend were traveling. The alleged incident happened on the China Road in Winslow back in October. No one was injured. Police found him with his tractor-trailer truck at the Irving Circle K truck stop in Fairfield the next day, where he surrendered. He was indicted on several other charges, including domestic violence, reckless conduct with a dangerous weapon, and reckless conduct with a dangerous weapon. Six people were indicted for an alleged assault in China. Police say the six allegedly entered a home on Alder Park Road, assaulted the homeowner, and took items, including guns. 22-year-old Carleek Hillcross, 21-year-old Joshua Baez, 24-year-old Michael Seegers, 20-year-old Janisha Boone, and 18-year-old Avion Melendez, as well as 18-year-old Kimora Wright, all from New York, were indicted for robbery, as well as other charges, including burglary and theft. Now, Melendez and Wright were also indicted on assault charges. Well, Maine's Attorney General has determined a Presque Isle police officer was justified when he used deadly force during an incident in June. According to documents, Sergeant Tyler Cody responded to reports of two people being threatened by a person with an AR-15 rifle. The report says 27-year-old Jacob Poitra of Presque Isle came up behind the people in his vehicle honking his horn, and the driver moved to another lane to allow him to pass, but Poitra allegedly pulled alongside them and told them to pull over. When they did, he allegedly emerged from his car with the gun, then sped off before police arrived. The next day, he allegedly rammed a police cruiser with a truck before taking off, and the report says he later put the truck in reverse and advanced towards Cody's cruiser at a high rate of speed before hitting it a second time. When Poitras' truck came at the cruiser a third time, it was higher off the ground, and the report says Sergeant Cody feared he would be seriously injured or killed if it came over the hood. Cody shot through the cruiser's windshield into the driver's side of the truck and killed Poitra. Well, $5 million in aid is headed to the Passamaquoddy tribe to address the impact of climate change. Maine's congressional delegation says the planning grant will be used to help the tribe respond to climate-related environmental threats from things like rising sea levels. The money was awarded through the U.S. Department of the Interior. In other news tonight, Governor Mills and legislative leaders are still working on an emergency winter heating relief plan. Details of that plan were expected to be released today. Governor Mills said earlier, though, this week that she was looking at financial relief for middle and lower income Mainers. And in a statement sent out this afternoon, the governor said in part, quote, "My office has had productive conversations with Democratic and Republican legislative leadership this week. And I am optimistic that we are close to finalizing a bipartisan agreement for an emergency winter energy relief plan," end quote. The governor said conversations will continue through the weekend, and she will unveil a proposal early next week for the legislature to consider before they convene on Wednesday. The Somerset County Commissioner's race still hasn't been decided, and Secretary of State Shenna Bellows has announced a recount will be held on Monday. Certified results show Joel Stetkus with 1,270 votes, Lloyd Trafton with 1,269 votes, Larrier Costa with 1,007, and Anthony Sparrow with 600. There were 711 blank ballots. Now, the recount was requested by Trafton, who lost by a single vote. Alrighty, well, let's hit pause here, take a look outside and see what's coming our way weather-wise with a first check of our forecast.
All right, Beth, thank you. Happy Friday. We made it. Your first weather is brought to you by Goose River Farm Meat Store. And here we go. The advisories are posted again. Another wet system is on the way and a windy system, too. We could see wind gusts tomorrow near 45 to 50 miles per hour with locally heavy rainfall back in the forecast for tomorrow. Not tonight, though, so the clouds are increasing out there now. Our next system is still way over here to the west of us. That is all moving in our direction. So clouds increase tonight. Rain and wind arrives for us throughout the day tomorrow. That rain could look really heavy and the wind as well. It's going to be all rain again, though, with temperatures hanging out in the mid-30s today. We could easily do low to mid-50s for high temperatures tomorrow. Our forecast then for tonight, though, is increasing clouds, low temperatures actually rising overnight to near 40 tonight by daybreak. Your full forecast is coming up. Beth?
Alrighty, Jeff, thanks so much. Well, coming up on ABC 7 News at 6, Hudson University students are putting their own spin, rather, on a holiday classic. And jobs for Maine grad students at Coney High School unveiled the results of their third annual Coney High School cereal drive. We'll have those stories and much more when ABC 7 News at 6 comes right back.
When outdoors, some people like it hot and some people like it cold. However, when indoors, most people like it comfortably warm. Choose a Badaris boiler from McCusick Petroleum Company to provide you with comfortable and efficient heat. They also offer sales and service on many brands of furnaces, boilers, and water heaters. McCusick Petroleum Company delivers oil and LP gas to homes and businesses throughout the Penquist region. If you'd like more information on pricing or service, call or stop by our office in Dover Foxcroft.
Al, did you make that call?
Honey, we already have Medicare. Why do I need to call?
Alan, the Feldman said we may be able to get additional benefits with a Medicare Advantage plan right here in our zip code with $0 monthly premiums.
Honey, what do you mean additional benefits? We turned 65, we got Medicare. That's all there is to it, right?
I'm talking about Medicare Part C, commonly called Medicare Advantage. We have traditional Medicare, which is only Medicare Parts A and B, but not Part C.
Wait. So not everyone on Medicare is a Part C plan?
No. That's why we need to call, because there may be plans available with additional benefits that aren't covered under Medicare Parts A and B. We don't have a Medicare Part C plan, which covers everything in Part A and Part B, plus extra benefits in Medicare Part C.
What kind of extra benefits?
There are great plans that may be available with extra benefits, like dental, vision, and hearing.
Did you say dental?
Yes, dental. Medicare Part C plans could include dental benefits that help cover routine dental exams and teeth cleanings, plus dental x-rays, fillings, gum disease treatment, and dentures.
We need that. I'm calling.
If you don't have a Medicare Part C plan, call now, because there may be plans with additional benefits available that are simply not covered under Medicare Parts A and B, like routine dental coverage. If you're on Medicare, you can call now during the Medicare annual enrollment period, even if you called last year. We will check to see if there is a Part C plan available in your area with additional benefits. You don't get a plan with additional benefits automatically, so call to speak with a licensed insurance agent right now during the Medicare annual enrollment period. Remember, you don't get Medicare Part C plan benefits benefits automatically. Call now for your free 2023 no obligation Medicare benefits review. Call 800-742-6905. 800-742-6905.
You're watching ABC 7 Bangor.
Just days to spare a potentially devastating rail worker strike has been averted. The Senate passed legislation compelling rail workers to accept an earlier tentative deal despite workers' complaints that it failed to meet some key demands. Before President Biden signed off on that strike-averting legislation today, he said he will continue fighting for rail workers. ABC's Justin Finch now has the latest from Washington.
After days of negotiations and votes on Capitol Hill, President Biden signed a bipartisan measure averting a coast-to-coast rail strike weeks before the holidays.
They did one heck of a job in averting what could have been a real disaster.
The legislation requires rail workers accept a tentative agreement the White House helped broker earlier this year. It calls for a $16,000 immediate payout with wage and benefit increases up to $160,000, a 24% pay raise, $5,000 performance bonuses, maintaining access to health care plans, and an additional day of paid personal leave.
You get sick, you got a mark against you, a couple of marks, you get fired. This cannot and must not happen in America in 2022.
Sick leave, a major sticking point in contract talks. The House passed a measure to give the rail workers 7 days of paid sick leave, but it failed in the Senate. President Biden pledging to keep up the fight.
But we still have more work to do, in my view, in terms of ultimately getting paid sick leave, not just for rail workers, but for every worker in America.
Still, leaders of at least four major unions worry this new deal falls short. This retired rail engineer now fears for rail workers' morale.
I can almost guarantee you that this time next year, you'll have fewer rail workers than you do right now.
And the president called on Congress to step in amid concerns the effects of a rail strike could begin well before a work stoppage ever began, what could have triggered an economic crisis. Justin Finch, ABC News, Washington.
Well, some college students are putting their own spin on a holiday classic. Hudson University Theater is putting on a production of Joe Landry's It's a Wonderful Life, a radio production. The show promises to be a mix of radio drama and live theater using a variety of props, costumes, and Foley sounds. The show is designed, directed, and performed by students, with many of them getting involved in the theater program for the first time.
This one's wicked different. I've never been a part of a student-producted show or directed show, and so it's very interesting to have the peer take of it.
Well, Bailey Aruda, one of the co-directors of the show, says that this show has been a great experience, but it hasn't been without some challenges.
It's a lot of work that goes into it, a lot that can go wrong. You need to be able to adapt to everything that could happen.
The show runs from December 2nd through December 4th in the Gracie's Black Box Theater. Admission is $5, but it's free for Hudson students. Well, jobs for Maine grad students at Coney High School unveiled the results of their third annual Coney High School Cereal Drive. Our Matthew Jaroncic was there for this sweet surprise.
3, 2, 1.
After fundraising for more than a month, the day is here. Students gathered in the auditorium to hear the final number of cereal boxes collected.
I am proud to announce that we exceeded our goal, collecting 2,130 boxes.
Cereal boxes were then packed up and sent to the Augusta Food Bank, where it will be passed out to those in need. JMG President Amani Al-Bahadli says the lessons they learned while doing this project far surpassed just collecting food for the homeless.
It means that we're helping our community, we're exceeding our goals, which is a good thing. We're teaching other people to be kind and put in the work to help others who are in need.
Coney JMG Specialist Shelley Kucher says the cereal drive was inspired by a Facebook post of kids doing a domino display through their school. So why not incorporate cereal boxes as dominoes and teach something about philanthropy in the process, one cereal box at a time? While everyone in the group understands the philosophy of philanthropy, Member Ahmad Asala says he helped out for a more personal reason.
A lot of people in our community cannot even afford food and stuff. And I used to be one of those part of families. Like, I used to go to food bank on Thursdays. Like, my parents used to go there and get, like, food for us. But now, right now, we can afford food and we can help out back to the community.
And you can be sure the Augusta Food Bank loved the outcome.
To me, to get an early start on what it means to be a philanthropist and what philanthropy is all about is really pretty heartwarming and inspiring.
The kids were able to collect almost 2,200 boxes of cereal, helping the Augusta community and showing some Coney Ram pride. Matthew Jaroncic, ABC 7 and Fox 22.
Well, the annual holiday tree lighting is underway in Belfast, and our David Ledford gives us an early look at the celebration.
In downtown Belfast, excited townsfolk have gathered in Post Office Square to celebrate the annual holiday tree lighting. It was originally scheduled to take place on Saturday, but was pushed up due to weather concerns. And despite that, people have gathered in droves to usher in the holiday season. And later tonight, both Santa and Mrs. Claus are going to come in a Belfast Fire Department vehicle. And adults and children alike are excited for the seasonal cheer that they'll bring with them. It's really a great atmosphere here tonight. We're just waiting for the lighting and Santa Claus. So back to you.
All righty, David, thank you for that. And we will have more from the celebration and lighting later on tonight. And still to come on ABC 7 News at 6, Fairfield Police announced that they will be hosting their annual Cops Care for Kids event. We'll have more on that. And in sports, Brewer girls basketball looking to once again qualify for the state tournament. How they plan to tackle that with a new head coach. That story right after the break.
You've probably seen those ads on TV with the out-of-state 800 number that look like information from Medicare. Some even suggest that your zip code will get you more benefits or even money back. You guessed it, those ads are misleading. So don't call that out-of-state 800 number when your help is right here at home. Do what I did and call the Senior Planning Center. They have trusted professionals all over Maine.
Call the Senior Planning Center at 223-6565. That's 223-6565.
At WKIT in the 90s, things were a little different. Now we take the rock very seriously. Still clowning around decades later. 100.3 WKIT. WKIT HD, Brewer, Bangor.
Hammond Lumber Company is honored to have again been named one of the best places to work in Maine. Hammond Lumber recognizes the importance of employee satisfaction. They provide a positive workplace environment with opportunities to grow. Hammond has continued to grow too, with more team members across Maine and New Hampshire. To find your place on the Hammond team, click on the careers link at hammondlumber.com. Hammond Lumber Company, proud to be one of the best places to work in Maine.
Porticall and Bucksport is closing its doors after 17 years in business. All inventory is on sale, including Christmas jewelry, pajamas, socks, imports, including Harris Tweed handbags, wallets and purses from Scotland, woolen scarves from Ireland, gloves, alpaca socks, scarves, and hats. Also, all fragrance gifts, including Inish fragrances from Ireland, man bar soaps, hand-painted silk scarves, plush toys, sleep hoodies, and so much more. Perfect for Christmas shopping. Porticall, 69 Main Street, Bucksport.
Gun Sports and Brewer knows that for fun, exercise, and meeting new friends, nothing is better than ice skating. Whether it's sailing down the ice, making a great pass, and scoring in a game of hockey, or the great strength and expression of figure skating. From the youngest child all the way to adulthood, anyone can enjoy the fun of skating. At Gun Sports, we supply the equipment for your skating fun for great prices, the proper fit, and service after the sale. Shop your locally owned Gun Sports Shop, Three Point Road in Brewer.
Tonight's sports is brought to you by Ansley Moore, a realtor since 2013, working throughout the state of Maine with both buyers and sellers with a focus on the greater Bangor area.
Hey everybody, Ryan Sudol here. Thanks for tuning in. It's that time of year. Of course, I mean basketball season. It's just 7 days away. Last year, the Brewer Witches girls team qualified for the Class A North tournament, but lost in the first round to Skowhegan. This year, they're out for better, and it all starts where it ended in February. Tyler Cruz has more.
The past is the past.
It's a new season, so like a new coach, so better things can happen.
The Brewer Witches are embracing the theme of newness in 2022.
We're a new, completely new family, new coach, new team, new philosophies. We need to put the past behind us and really just kind of focus on the future and what this program has to offer.
Leading them into battle this winter is first-year head coach Chad Labrie. But he's not unfamiliar with the program.
I was here in 2017 and 2018 with Coach Hoare, so I was the JV coach here.
Labrie takes over a Witches team that made the tournament last year, but dropped the opening game to the eventual champs, Skowhegan. And that's where their season begins.
I mean, it sucks to lose going first into the tournament, so it's like we obviously want to have a better setup than that.
It's going to be so good. It's going to be a good game.
But before that, the Witches have had quite an impressive preseason so far. They opened up with four scrimmages up in the county last weekend and came home with three wins.
Just winning games coming from a season last year and the year before where we just didn't win like we wanted to, and just starting off with those three wins was just really good.
It just like it proves to us, like we put in the work, we come to practice, we put it all out on the court, and then when you see us actually win, it's just like we can see it and we can do that.
But heading into the year, they know it's going to be a learning curve. So what's the old cliche? One game at a time.
So we're going to take one game at a time and make sure that we do our best job when we get out on the court.
I feel like we're just learning new stuff too, like our plays and everything, and just trying to get to know each other better also.
Reporting in Brewer, I'm Tyler Cruz, ABC 7, Fox 22 Sports.
Thank you, Tyler. Can't wait to see that game next Friday. Now for some NFL. The Patriots faced off against the high-octane Buffalo Bills on Thursday Night Football, but they couldn't get their own offense off the ground. The Bills would score 21 unanswered points after being down 7-3 early, with Josh Allen throwing for over 200 yards and two touchdowns. The Bills would win the game 24-10 and hand the Pats their second straight loss, dropping them to 6-6 on the year. And the Pats going 3-for-12 on third downs definitely did not help matters. Quarterback Mac Jones took full responsibility for the offense's struggles after the game.
When you're playing from behind against a really good team and a good offense, you need to go out there and make better plays, and that starts with me. So definitely wasn't good enough by me tonight, and all you can do is watch the tape and see where we can get better. But playing catch-up's hard. We didn't want to do that all game, and I didn't do a good enough job getting ahead early and making it work. So
the Pats will try to break their drought on the road against the Cardinals Monday night. That's all the time we have for sports. I'm Ryan Sudol. Here's Jeff Weller with your full five-day forecast. Jeff.
Brought to you by Varney Ford, the nice car and truck people, and we have a lot to talk about tonight. Here are the advisories across the region. A high wind warning again, wind advisories, also high surfs in there, as a rainy and windy system is on the way. The second one in a week, it's going to bring us those high winds tomorrow and locally heavy rainfall. Okay, so right now the wind is changing, right? It's been out of the north pretty much all day long today. It's going to turn out of the south later on tonight and get really gusty once again. We could see wind gusts near 45 miles per hour overnight tonight and then throughout the day tomorrow as well. Right now, temperature-wise today, we had a high of 37 here in Bangor, also for Bar Harbor, 32 for Millinocket. So, you know, this is about what we're supposed to do, but not so much tomorrow. Tomorrow we're going to hang out in the low to mid-50s as a surge of warm air is on the way. That will keep everything rain tomorrow. No snow for you. Maybe a little bit of snow later on next week. All right, so out there today we had increasing clouds throughout the day today. The radar is beginning to pick up a few things. Nothing really big, though. The bigger system is still way over here across the Great Lakes area. That is going to bring us that weather for tomorrow. And there is a lot going on here. Lots of energy in the atmosphere, lots of cloud cover, and lots of precipitation. So expect rain tomorrow afternoon and evening-ish. That rain locally heavy along with that windy condition as well. Let's walk it through. So tonight we have increasing clouds out there now. By tomorrow morning, still dry tomorrow morning, but by, say, midday or so, we're talking about that locally heavy rainfall. Again, all rainfall and wind. Those wind gusts are 45 to 50 miles per hour throughout the day tomorrow. We're going to feel that again, just like we did the other day as the system pulls out of here tomorrow night. Behind it, it's still windy tomorrow night, and a couple of snow flurries are likely across the area late tomorrow evening before it all kind of gets out of here on Sunday into Monday, as we have pretty nice days around here then. Okay, so rainfall-wise, looks like this. A widespread kind of quarter to a half inch of rain, although a couple of you could easily do closer to an inch, especially coastal down east areas throughout the day tomorrow. All right, so here's the snow, and there's just not any of it, right? We're not getting much snow at all this year so far, and we're going to keep this one as rain tomorrow, also probably later on early next week with temperatures way too warm for that snow. Our forecast then tonight, though, is mostly cloudy or increasing clouds. Rising temperatures overnight tonight after lows near 30 are going to rise to near 40 by daybreak tomorrow. For tomorrow, here we go. So rain and wind again. Look at that high temperature up near 53 with a south wind could gust near 45 to 50 miles per hour once again with the advisories in place throughout the day tomorrow. And then looking ahead, your five-day forecast shows the story, right? We're talking about temperatures hanging out in the 50s Saturday, 30s though Sunday. And look at Monday, 42, 48 for Tuesday with rain showers. Back in the 50s with rain showers on Wednesday. Beth?
All righty, Jeff, thanks so much. Well, there is still more to come right after the break. Stay with us.
Do you have leaky pipes? Are you planning a plumbing job? Is your heating system working right? Are you designing a plumbing project? Then contact Harley's Plumbing and Heating Plus.
If your toilet will not flush, Harley will be there in a rush. Furnace bit the dust today. Harley crew is on the way. Harley Plumbing, Harley Heating.
990-2200.
Call now.
Harley!
Call or visit online.
At Firehouse Subs, we give you craveable subs that are piping hot and piled high. And a portion of every purchase helps give them the life-saving equipment they need. Order online or on the app for contactless pickup or delivery. Only at Firehouse Subs.
Hi, I'm Angelina Mucci.
And I'm Andy Mucci of Family Fun Bowl and Center.
When we want to know the weather, we go to foxbangor.com.
Celebrating our 50th anniversary year, Family Fun Bowling Center has 20 lanes of 10-pin bowling at its best.
So small, so smart. Hearing aids that I can personalize to each ear right from here. Brilliant.
It's Cyber Monday all week with big savings on Ergo 6.
An official message from Medicare.
Often things look the same. Exactly the same. Until you take a closer look. At Medicare.gov, you can easily compare Medicare plans and see the real difference. Find a plan that offers you more or saves money. Wouldn't that be nice? Plans change every year. So can your health. Open enrollment ends December 7th. Compare now at Medicare.gov.
Paid for by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
Hey, it's Eric from Green Bear 420. We've been in business since 2010 and going strong, so stop in and check us out. We specialize in glass art by over 100 local artists and even have live glass blowing. Plus, we carry incense, novelties, t-shirts, and hard-to-find items. We have tons of local products for the tie-dye wearing person in your circle of friends. Come see us at 531 Moosehead Trail in Newport. And remember, Green Bear 420, it's not just a store, it's a lifestyle.
Tonight, falling prices at the pump. How low could they go? Plus, Made in America is back for the holidays. More Americans turn to the most watched newscast on television, World News Tonight with David Muir.
Closer to Christmas, Fairfield Police announced that they will be hosting their annual Cops Care for Kids event, but with a bit of a twist. The event was started in 2006 by former police detective Kingston Paul, and it is available for all kids living in Fairfield. Now, officers usually drive to homes donating 3 wrapped gifts and a stuffed animal. The department is now inviting kids from the area to come to the Fairfield Community Center on the 15th and 16th to get their presents. Each officer donates money weekly to the program. They also do some of the shopping for the gifts themselves. Fairfield Police Patrol Officer Casey Dugas says this event helps bring the community together.
The kids love it, the parents love it, and it's something that brings us all together this time of year. And like I said, it gives the kids and their families a chance to see us in a more positive light.
Well, families can still request to have their gifts delivered to their homes, and those who attend the event in person will be able to watch a movie and enjoy a little hot cocoa. So I guess you get the best of both worlds. You can either get door delivery service or have yourself a little hot cocoa and go get some presents. Alrighty, folks. Well, that is going to do it for us. From everyone here at ABC 7 News, take care and have a great rest of your night.